going on? Happy New Year's. Today we're going to be talking about fraud orders, the sacred subject, everything that nobody wants to deal with, but I'm going to talk about it here today. So fraud orders, especially if you're doing worldwide targeting and you're following my strategy, you'll come across them. And you know, there's hot spots in countries, there's countries that you want to avoid, there's signs that you can tell, but that's not what we're going to be talking about today. We're going to be talking about how to manage your risk and make the right decisions when it comes to fraud orders. Now, it is about risk, and most people don't know this, and if you're refunding every single fraud order that comes through, you might be making a mistake, you might just be managing your risk. Maybe that's what you want to do. That's what I do personally. I mean, I've taken the risk many times, and usually it doesn't work out in my favor. And I end up losing a little bit of money on it. So I just want to make it aware to you that you do not have to place a fraud order. You can refund a fraud order. You can refund it and pretend that it never happened. You can refund it, reach out to the customer, and if they really want it, they can place the order again. And you can try to figure out why it comes out fraud. But every time you ask them, is this order fraudulent? Like, are you trying to scam me? Obviously, they're going to tell you no because they want to scam you. So it's a hard thing to deal with, especially if you don't have a lot of money, you know, that extra order, you know, usually fraud orders are a little bit big, so it gets a little bit tempting sometimes. But yeah, fraud orders, man, like if you don't have a lot of money, it's tempting to just take the risk and play it, but I want you to understand what could happen. So what is a fraud order? Why does Shopify warn you about it? And what are the potential consequences if you do proceed to place that fraud order and the worst case scenario happens, which is the order is fraud? So I want you to understand that orders come in as fraud even when they're not. Okay, so it could be a normal person, it could be just somebody not trying to fraud you, and the order will still come in as fraud. It's perfectly fine, but there's different things that you can understand about the order details and looking at the fraud summary that can tell you whether it's fraud or not. But yeah, that's what I want you to understand, that not every fraud order is a fraud order. But what other thing that I want you to understand is Shopify and Stripe have a database of debit cards, names, addresses, all these sorts of things, and you're not the only person that, if somebody is doing fraud, they're doing it on multiple Shopify stores, they're doing it on, you know, multiple addresses, multiple debit cards, and Shopify knows best, right? Like they process a lot of money every year. They have a lot of customers, have a huge database of customers. And if one customer, it's not guaranteed that they do this, it's just a theory that I have, but if somebody makes a chargeback, they're kind of put on that fraud list where if they place an order on another Shopify store, it might come through as a medium risk for fraud just because they did a chargeback in the past with another store. So that could be one reason. Another reason is, if, like, let's say I'm in Connecticut and I want to order it and my billing address is in Connecticut, but I'm shipping it to California, it could look a little bit suspicious, kind of like I'm using a fake debit card, or, you know, like if I live in California and I'm shipping it from a billing address in Connecticut, it could come up as fraud. So sometimes it's just a normal person. Like when I was in Los Angeles, I ordered this tripod that I'm using here, and I used a billing address from Connecticut. So it probably came up as fraud on their end, but again, I was just a normal guy who was traveling who needed a tripod from Amazon. So, you know, they chose to take the risk. You know, sometimes you might get refunded, whatever, or you can give refunds, right? But those are some things, but that's what fraud is, right? Is basically Stripe is suspicious that this order is fraudulent. Now, I want to talk about what specifically could happen if a fraud order was fraudulent, and also why does Stripe and Shopify tell you this? So basically they're telling you to protect themselves. They don't care about you, they don't care about your money. You know, obviously they're giving you a little warning, but essentially if somebody buys an item through Stripe and then issues Stripe for a refund, Stripe has already paid you that money. So they're basically giving a refund to that person or a chargeback out of their exchange, I mean, out of their funds. So they now have to come after you, the Shopify store owner, to get those funds back, or they'll take it out of your next payment. So Stripe and PayPal, they don't really want fraud orders at all. And you can actually go into your Stripe account and look at how many orders actually get blocked that they just flat out will not accept. The fraud ones that come through, those are high risk of fraud, but it's not like a guaranteed fraud. The guaranteed fraud ones, they don't even let the money transfer. They'll just shut them down right at the checkout. So Stripe is basically just protecting themselves. They don't care about you. They're warning you because they don't want you to take the risk. But obviously, if you want to, it's on you. Now, what is the risk? Okay, so either, let's say you're selling a product for $100 and it costs you $30. So let's say you get a fraud order and you want to take the risk, right? The risk to reward is you can either lose the original $100 that you got from the sale plus the $30 that you shipped the product out with, because you will not get a refund on that. And also, a lot of people don't know this, but there's actually a chargeback acceptance fee of $15. So the amount of money that you have on the line to lose is $145. And the amount of money that you have on the line to make, if it wasn't a fraud order, is $70, because your product costed you $100. I mean, because you sold the product for $100 and the product cost you $30. So it's either you make $70 or you lose $140. And those odds sound good, sound bad, whatever. But it's usually a 50-50 chance, and there's ways to mitigate it, right? Like, you can reach out to the customer, like I was talking about. But, you know, just use your common sense, manage your risk really well, and you shouldn't have a problem with it. But now I'm going to tell you what I do specifically. So when I get a fraud order, they'll always give either an email or a phone number. Usually it'll be a fake email, or they won't give a phone number at all. But still, what I do is I will instantly refund the order and just pretend that I never got it, because obviously the satisfaction of having a sale is unexplainable. Like, it feels really good, you know, you got a customer and stuff, but I just don't want to risk it. You know, I know the risk to reward, and it's really not worth it for me. Plus, I'm trying to keep a good relationship with Stripe, and it's just not worth it to me as well. So I'll refund it instantly. And right after I refund it, I'll go send an email to the customer. If they have a phone number, I'll call them and I'll say, hey, your order came through as being a high risk of fraud. Now, this could have been because, you know, your billing address didn't match your IP address. Whatever the reason was, I don't really care. I just don't feel comfortable placing this order. So I just went ahead and gave you a refund. Please feel free to go back to our store and repurchase. And as long as it doesn't come in as fraudulent or a risk of fraud, I'll go ahead and place it. Now, that way I know that if it's really somebody who wants the item, they'll respond, they'll try to work it out. They'll try to work it out as best as they can if they really want the item. And also, I know that I'm not risking making anything and I'm not risking losing anything. It's kind of like it didn't even happen. But sending that email adds the extra little chance that they're going to come back and buy something and it won't come through as fraud. So that's how I deal with fraud orders. That's my take on fraud orders. I know other people have different opinions, different ways that they manage their risk, but that's what I do. I just wanted to talk about that here today. But as for this video, this is Noah Brewer, and I'm out. Peace.